Welcome back to Soldier Field and another week of Illinois Tech Wolfpack football. It's time for the home opener as the Wolfpack are looking for another big program win against the 1-0 Purdue Boilermakers. This season started off in a strong note with a huge road win over number 8 Louisville, and with a week to prepare, the Wolfpack are ready to go at it again against a Purdue team with a big injury to their starting quarterback. It's also a big injury for Illinois Tech as returner Lucas Baker's out for a couple of weeks with a torn pec. And that'll shift things up in the return game along with the receiving corps. Torrios gets the opening kickoff of this ball game, gets around the edge, and is going to find a 35-yard return to get this game started. So here comes the Wolfpack offense led by quarterback Sean Kelly. Great game in week one. The main reason, or one of the big reasons, why the Wolfpack won in week one is they go screen on first down against a blitz and find a 9-yard gain to T.C. Shelton. Great play call there as that gets them down to the 45. This is a carry for Bishop, powering his way behind the left side of that line, hoping for a little more production from the O-line this week. They had a rough time against the Cardinals in week one. Kelly to throw on first down. Down the seam, trying to find Archer, and just a little too far in front. And that'll bring up second down. Kelly didn't miss a lot of throws last week, despite the two INTs. Very efficient as a second down carry to Bishop's going to find a 1-yard gain, as Bishop probably looking for a block from the pulling guard. Didn't get it. Third down and 9. Kelly throwing this one downfield and somehow finding the freshman Torrios for a 28-yard pickup. The safety in the area, that was a bad decision there from Kelly, but somehow this safety can't make the play. Torrios just rips it out of his hand. And that's going to equal a big-time first down for the Wolfpack, already nearing the red zone early in this ball game. Second and 8. Kelly to throw again. Pressure coming through, and Kelly to the outside, and that's way off the mark for Archer. 3-for-5 start for Kelly today, and both of the incompletions have been thrown towards Archer. Third and 8, Bishop out the backfield as Kelly looks to throw, and will throw this one towards the sideline for Torrios, and that one's out of bounds as well. Illinois Tech forced to kick this one for 3 points as Gonzalez from 40 in the left hash puts this one through, and the Wolfpack are on the board first. Studio update as the Volunteers have taken down the Sooners. Another upset in the top 10. How many times are we going to see that happen this week? Boilermakers from the 31-yard line to get their drive started. This is Elijah Sinnelar, the backup QB, throwing on first down and finding receiver Terrence Landers for a 15-yard completion. One of the bright spots for the Wolfpack defense in week one was the pass defense, says Sinnelar throws again towards Landers. That'll get Purdue into Wolfpack territory at the Illinois Tech 40. Sindelar from the shotgun gives it to the running back in Markell Jones. His first carry ends up losing 6 yards. Great pressure brought there by corner Ashley Curtis. He is asked to do a lot for this defense. Get to the quarterback, stop the run, and you know, sometimes drop back in the coverage. Second and 16. Corbin gets pressure for the first time this year, but somehow Sindelar shrugs him away and finds 27 yards. Great block shift there. Good pressure, but somehow Sindelar gets away from Thomas Corbin. And not a lot of people can say that. Corbin was a machine last year. Not a great start to this season as Markell Jones carries for a 9-yard gain to bring up 3rd and 1 for Purdue. Sindelar from the shotgun again. They will throw. Sindelar time. Throws this one deep, and this one is going out the back of the end zone. Good coverage downfield. Just couldn't get pressure on the quarterback, but the Purdue offense stays on the field. Illinois Tech will bring heat. 4th and 1. Sindelar hit as he throws, finding Javonte Ferguson. And a touchdown for the Boilermakers puts them on the board, and they take the lead in the first quarter. The pressure nearly got there, but Jamal Dwyer, I don't know what happened here. We saw the same thing happen in week one. We're trying to jam at the line, and for some reason, we're just not getting the jam animation, and then my defenders get messed up. Illinois Tech from the 25 on offense as Kelly drops back, quick pass to the tight end turn fullback Jay Miller. And a good completion, good for 6 yards. Miller's really adopted that fullback role quite well as Illinois Tech goes to the run on second down. And a big block by the left tackle, Joe Corbett, leading the way for Bishop. 9-yard gain and a first down at the 40-yard line. Kelly again throwing on first down. This is a check down to the freshman Torrios. And another catch for him gets Illinois Tech into Purdue territory just barely. That's good for 12 yards. Second down and 9, Wolfpack to throw, Kelly no one open, and we'll throw this one into a void as that will go incomplete and bring up 3rd down. Trying to find a way to keep the drive alive, Kelly lobbing this one outside, he's got Archer, he's missed twice but finds him on 3rd down, and Archer inside the red zone, down to the 5-yard line, that's good for 44 yards. Illinois Tech looking to quickly retake the lead as Caden Garrett checks in on 1st and goal, gets the football, and we'll carry this one for a short 1-yard gain. That'll bring up 3rd and goal a couple plays later. Devontae McCullough checks in. Bishop in the backfield with him. They'll go option. McCullough keeps it. It is met at the goal line, but spins in for the touchdown. He's got a big frame and used it there to get in for the score. Illinois Tech retakes the lead with a little time left in the first quarter. Can the defense play a little better this time around against the air? This is Sindelar throwing outside and another catch for Terrence Landers. There goes number three. They'll go from the shotgun to the pistol on second down as Markel Jones moves out to the left. He'll come back in the block, and this is a throw from Sindelar. He finds a receiver, and this could be trouble for the Wolfpack as this will be a big-time gain. Good for 7 yards for Anthony Mahoungau. Try saying that three times very quickly as Gabe Hunter's there to make the tackle in the red zone. But here goes Purdue from the 10, and a check down to Ferguson. Nice catch and a short gain. Good for 5. First quarter pretty much wrapped up. 14 seconds left. Sindelar again will throw. They'll try to go screen on 3rd down and 5, and this will go incomplete, but there's a flag. And there's going to be pass interference on the defense. They're going to get Xavier Hunter with defensive pass interference and give the Purdue Boilermakers a new set of downs. Xavier trying to get to the screen coverage, gets engaged in a block. How was that pass interference? That'll somehow back Purdue up to the 12-yard line as they'll go to the ground with Jones, and Xavier Hunter a little pissed off as he gets a big stop behind the line. That'll bring up 3rd and 9, Purdue from the shotgun. Sindelar looking to throw again, steps to his right, throws to his left. This is Landers in the end zone, and Purdue finds a touchdown anyway. There were way too many blue uniforms on that side of the field to allow that score. Jack Cobb's in man coverage. This is not where he excels. He is not great in man coverage. And he was looking right at Landers, but somehow couldn't stay with him. Purdue on the board again as they put up 2 straight touchdowns. Defense has to find a way to get some stops, and the Wolfpack offense has to find a way to get back in the end zone again as Bishop carrying outside and a pretty good run there, good for 14 yards. Say what you will about this team, this offense does not mess around. 2nd and 11, Kelly to throw again, and everyone covered downfield, but Bishop out the backfield finding 11 yards. That'll bring up 3rd and inches. Purdue looking to stack the box on 3rd and inches, and Illinois Tech will run the ball towards them anyway. This is Bishop getting around the edge, finding a 1st down. That's good for 9. This offensive line getting the job done against Purdue this ball game. 2nd and 5 as Garrick checks in, but Kelly going play action, forced to his left, and will check it down to the freshman Fred Edwards, who ends up losing 1 yard in the process. So another 3rd down coming up for the offense. Kelly looking to throw again and quickly checks it down to Brandon Archer. What a move for the 1st down. That's good for 9 yards. A little bit of shake and bake going on there. Showing off the dance moves, but another 3rd down for this offense. They just can't avoid 3rd downs as Kelly pressure somehow avoids a sack. Throws it dangerously in the traffic for McKnight. And this is going to be another field goal attempt for Gonzalez. This one from a little further out, 41 yards. Gonzalez again from the left hash is good. Back on defense, and here comes Purdue with about 2.5 minutes left in the first half. Can this defense keep them out the end zone? And not off to a great start there as Sindelar finds Matt Burke for 7 yards. 2nd and 3, Sindelar again looking to throw. And throws this one again towards Burke, and Brock Darby has to make him pay for that. That should have been a pick 6. 3rd down coming up for Purdue. Sindelar again throwing in the traffic, and this is not knocked away by Jamal Dwyer. This Anthony Mahoungau again with the catch. 2nd down, Purdue. Sindelar all day to throw as he fires towards the outside, and that's going to be a completion for Matt Burke again. Sindelar just getting whatever he wants this ball game. This time pressure's brought, and he finds again Matt Burke for another completion. In the red zone, Sindelar to throw in, checks down to Landers. Landers going to find a couple yards there. That's good for 7. Boilermakers down to 1 more timeout. 2nd and 3 is Sindelar looks to throw again. Pressured, and there goes the pressure we've been looking for. And it's the 1st sack of the year for this team. That is Kent Huggins. And look at what he did here. I mean, this is kind of impressive, the size difference between him and that right tackle. And somehow finds a way to get the Sindelar. I mean, don't get me wrong. Kent Huggins has the skill set to be a great pass rusher for this team. But his size is definitely an issue. 3rd and 12 for Purdue. Sindelar clean pocket again. Hit by Hunter throwing towards the end zone. What is going on with this defense? Another touchdown in the red zone. The 1st 2 given up by man coverage. This time is zone. And it was a perfect call, but Dwyer not in the area he needed to be. This secondary is starting to look a lot like last year's secondary, despite the great start in week 1, as McKnight's on the return, looking to weaving his way through the kick coverage and nearly getting to the 30-yard line, brought down just shy, but a 36-yard return. And here goes Kelly with a minute 13 left, throwing to Bishop underneath as everyone else is covered downfield. 58 seconds left. Kelly again will throw. This is T.C. Shelton. Purdue not doing a great job of protecting the flats as Shelton finds a first down and gets the Wolfpack to midfield. Five wide set for Kelly as he will throw this one underneath. There is Jason Howard with a nice grab for 5 yards. And there goes the first timeout call for the Wolfpack this half. Still have two left and a little ways to go before getting into field goal range. Third down, Kelly checking it down to McKnight. Going to find about 4 yards there. Still a little shy. And there goes the other timeout. One left for the Wolfpack. Fourth and two. Might as well go for it here as Kelly looks to throw against a three-man rush and finds Jason Howard again. 4 yard gain. That'll get the Wolfpack a first down. 9 seconds left. Kelly again looking to throw quickly across the middle. There goes Howard. And the Wolfpack are into field goal range. And that ball is perfectly teed up. But they're going to keep the offense on the field. One more timeout. Option left. Kelly loses the football. Scooped up by Kasten. And there goes the end of the first half. They got a little too greedy there. Trying to go option against the weak side of the defense. Probably could have been a big play there. But the Purdue defense makes them pay and keeps us at an 8-point ball game as we are heading to halftime. Illinois Tech down by 2 scores, but this is familiar territory as we will head to the third quarter. Purdue getting the football first to begin the second half, and you know there's a little bit of pressure on them. They saw the week one film and the upset win over Louisville. They have to score here to keep some pressure on this Wolfpack team. This is a return from Hunt, and he's going to find 18 yards. Purdue getting this drive started through the air. Sindelar rolling out to his right, throwing off his back foot, launching this ball downfield and finding Ferguson for a first down. And there's a flag down at the end of the play. They're going to get Illinois Tech for roughing the passer. So add 15 yards to the end of that throw. And it's already a red zone trip for Purdue. This defense already in trouble in the second half. Is that ball is tipped at the line of scrimmage by Kent Huggins. Great play there. But now it's 3rd and 4 for the Boilermakers from the 11-yard line. Sindelar again looking to throw. They are not running the ball in the red zone as he is nearly brought down by Corbin. Forced to throw, and that ball is out the back of the end zone. And they will just settle for 3 this time around. Could have been a lot worse, especially how that drive started. Kickoff returned by McKnight again. And this time trying to find some space. Look at the block upfield by Jay Miller. Another block from Jay Miller. That frees McKnight up down the sideline with one more man to beat inside the 20. He's going to beat him. And he's in for the touchdown. That's good for 104 yards. The momentum has shifted. You can just feel it in this home environment. And look at the blocking upfield. You might have missed it. But Jay Miller, tight end turn fullback, takes out the tight end for Purdue and takes out their other tight end. And pretty much frees McKnight up for a big-time score. Trying to make it a 3-point ball game. Currently down by 5 in the third quarter. This is going to be a carry outside for Bishop. He's got the edge, and he is in for the score. This is a 3-point ball game just like that. But can this defense finally step up and make some plays as Sindelar checks it down again to Landers? He's been pretty much open in the flat all ball game, and that finds 8 yards. 2nd and 2, Sindelar screen. This is going to be broken up by Dwyer, nearly picked off. That brings up a big-time 3rd down. Can the defense get off the field here? 3rd and 2, Sindelar again will throw outside, finds Burke, and he's got just enough for a 1st down. That's good for 3. Just too many holes in this secondary. Some guys are good in man. Some guys are good in zone. They just don't have a complete defense right now as Markell Jones gets his first carry of the second half. That's good for no gain. 2nd and 10, Sindelar again throwing. This is going to be a catch by Burke, and he's going to find himself near the first down marker. Good for 9. But 311 yards so far for this Purdue offense through the air as they go back to Jones, and he finds 5 yards. That's good for a 1st down. Purdue already getting back near the red zone. 1st and 10, they go back to Jones, and a big blitz coming off the edge by Ashley Curtis again brings Jones down in the backfield. They get those 3 yards back on 2nd down. 3rd and 10, going to a screen. This time is not going to be a pass interference call, but a short gain, another 3-yard gain. And the Purdue Boilermakers kept to another field goal. So Purdue keeps adding points, but the defense keeping it at a 1-score ball game. McKnight deep for the return. This one a little deeper than the last one, but he will bring this one out the end zone regardless. Looking for blocks upfield and can't get one from Torrios. He just let the guy run right past him. But Jay Miller, another great block downfield if you could see that. Down by 6, a lot of time left in the ball game, and they start from the 14 as Kelly looks to throw in a strike downfield to the freshman Fred Edwards. And he finds a big gain, good for 32 yards. But they find themselves needing another 3rd down conversion. 3rd and 6, Kelly clean pocket, finds Howard. Howard crossing the marker and then clobbered by 5 Purdue defenders. That did not look fun. Illinois Tech from the 45-yard line trying to go screen to McKnight. Great play call there as he finds a solid gain, good for 9. That's been one of the key play calls for this offense when they see off coverage. And here goes a 2nd-and-1 carry for Caden Garrick, finding a first down. That's good for 7. Garrett getting more of a workload this week, already 4 carries and 14 yards compared to 2 last week. Illinois Tech inside the 25, a shifty move there from Bishop, finding 5 yards. Looked like he was going to lose about 3 or 4 yards that time around. From the 22, McKnight the man in motion. This is going to be a jet sweep right, Bishop leading the way. McKnight already inside the 15, inside the 10, and down to the 5-yard line. What a play call. They ran it against the weak side of the defense. They rolled a safety down on the blitz. And McKnight having a huge impact in this ball game. The kick return, a couple of clutch catches. And, of course, that jet sweep. Garrett checking back in on 1st-and-goal. This is going to be an option. Kelly keeping it working left, and he's in for the score. His 2nd touchdown of the season on the ground. Had 1 in week 1, another one here in week 3. And Illinois Tech has tied this ball game up at 27. The extra point will give them a 1-point lead. Gonzalez puts it through. And this home crowd is enjoying a good one again. This Wolfpack team has not lost at home yet in program history. And looking to keep that going here with a 4th quarter looming. But this defense has got to find a way to get this Purdue offense off the field. This Sindelar throws again. And a tight throw to Cole Herdman. Good for 5 yards. Big 3rd down coming up for the Boilermakers. Down by 1. Need to keep this drive alive as Sindelar throws this one downfield. And Ferguson can't hold on. Knocked away by David Davis. And that's going to bring on the 1st punt for either team today. McKnight back there for the return. This is going to be returned from inside the 25. And McKnight trying to find some room to work with. Weaving through their kick coverage again. He's been an absolute weapon as that'll take us to the 4th quarter. And Illinois Tech has really trailed behind Purdue in terms of yardage. But they found a way to make it work. 2nd-and-6 going to Bishop. And he spun down. It looked like that was by the face mask. But no call from the officials. But Bishop finding 8 yards there. 10th carry of the ball game. Now as Garrick checking in, they keep going back and forth with the running backs as Caden Garrick brings the thunder and powers ahead for a 6-yard gain. Now it's Bishop back in the ball game on 2nd down. Gets it up the middle once again. Bishop showing off the speed and the lightning as he finds 12 yards. Already back in the field goal range. A lot of time left in this game though. 6:40 to go. 1st-and-10 for Kelly from the pistol, trying to set up a screen, and this is going to be broken up as Kelly spun down. Purdue really catching a break there because their defense was not ready for that. 2nd-and-10, play action from the pistol. Kelly looking for someone downfield, but Purdue locking him up. Absolutely nowhere to go with the football as Gellin Robinson gets through. That brings up 3rd-and-21. From the shotgun, Illinois Tech going to a screen. This is Bishop working outside. He's got a block from Torrios. Already has the 1st down inside the 5-yard line. Didn't need the block anyway. There goes a 35-yard touchdown on a screen on 3rd-and-21. This team just finds ways to score in ridiculous ways. 3rd-and-21, perfect blocking upfield. Bishop showing off the wheels. Also shows off pretty great vision. And thankfully, no one dumb enough to get called for a block in the back. Jason Howard pretty close there. But Illinois Tech now up by 8 points. They have completely flipped the table on Purdue. They've got about 5 minutes to get down the field and try to tie this ball game up as Mark Hill Jones gets the carry. And that's the 13th time they run the ball so far this game. 1st-and-10, Sindelar again to the outside. There's Landers. Another short catch, good for 4 yards. They keep working that sideline, and this defense has to take that away from them. 2nd-and-6, Sindelar keeping it on the inverted veer and finding nowhere to go. Good tackle there by Paul McCray to force a big-time 3rd down. Can the defense get off the field again? 3rd-and-6 from midfield. Sindelar, time to throw, lobbing it outside, and this is going to be thrown out of bounds. 4th down and 6, but the offense stays on the field. Already with 1 touchdown given up on 4th down. Here goes 4th and 6. Sindelar swinging it out. There's a running back. Knocks no one there. And he finds a 1st down, runs through Davis, and picks up 14 yards. No one in the flat. That was the last place Illinois Tech expected someone to get the football. Here goes Knox on 1st down, carrying outside 1st and 15, and finding 13 yards. So Purdue pacing pretty well here. 3.5 minutes to go in the 4th quarter. And they'll go back to Knox on the ground. A great tackle there from Jack Cobbs. Hurrying back to the line, back in this power set from the pistol. And going back to Knox, working his way towards the left side. Runs through Gabe Hunter, runs through Davis, and he's in the end zone. What a run from DJ Knox as Purdue has kind of abandoned their pass game and has really relied on the run game this drive. And DJ Knox just running completely through this defense. Davis couldn't make the tackle. Kent Huggins couldn't make the tackle. Jack Cobbs there to make the tackle in the end zone. But here goes the two-point conversion needed to tie the ball game up. They go back to Jones, and he's shut down by Xavier Hunter and Paul McCray. So a little time left in the ball game. Purdue definitely needs to get the ball back, but Illinois Tech will take over and just look to run out the clock with the remaining time left on the board. And when you're looking to pound away on the clock, you got to bring in the big bruiser. This is Caden Garrick on first down and powering his way ahead for an 8-yard gain. He's had a much bigger role this week than in week one. Only 2 carries in week one, now finding a lot of carries. This is third down, big third down, and the defense not even looking to stop the run. Purdue forced to call their first time out there. Now Bishop checks in the ball game. First and 10, and this is a carry outside, and Bishop's got a first down and staying in bounds smartly. That was an issue for him last year, doing a lot of running out of bounds when they're trying to keep this clock milked. One timeout left for the Boilermakers. First and 10, carry for Garrick, and he's going to cross the 40, and there goes the final timeout. Minute 22 away from another Illinois Tech win, and here goes a third down carry for Bishop, and he stopped before he can get the first down, but that will keep the clock moving as they now face 4th and 3. Keeping the offense on the field, just looking to keep this clock moving any way possible, and they give to Bishop out of the power set, and the defense wasn't even looking to stop the run again. It's the same formation from earlier, and they came out only rushing 4, no linebackers blitzed prematurely, no corners coming off the edge. And they made that a little too easy for the Wolfpack. And that is going to seal this ball game. Kelly out in the victory formation. He will take a knee with 8 seconds left. And there is your second win of the season. 2 non-conference games and 2 big wins. And the Wolfpack just keep on winning. Kelly, another player of the game, 2 games in a row. This time taking on the neighbors from Indiana. Next week, taking on the neighbors from Cincinnati, the Bearcats. So Kelly, another great game. No interceptions this time around, only that one lost fumble. That's his only turnover, which is okay. He had another fumble earlier on. It wasn't that big of a deal. Bishop, another 100-yard game. And then through the air, a lot of guys touching the football this week. And Bishop, probably the biggest one with that big-time screen reception. Got to get him more involved in the pass game. But the defense, I don't know what's going on with this defense right now. As you see, no tackles for Quentin McKenzie. The freshman really on fire in week one and just not finding anything going this week as we get our first sack of the year with Kent Huggins. But we got to find a way to get more pressure, and McKenzie just can't disappear. I mean, we came out in a lot of different sets this game. We tried blitzing from different positions, different locations, and we just could not get consistent pressure. And the times that we did, it was either a run or it was a missed sack or someone just completely messed up. So we're going to try to get this fixed for week 4 in Cincinnati against the Bearcats. But just reflecting on this game, not bad. Third downs, 8 of 12, Purdue 5 of 10. I mean, not a ton of stuff to complain about this game, but obviously it could have been a lot better. So we'll move into week 4. As you guys know, you're taking on the Bearcats, and we've got a lot of guys ready to visit. Quarterback Harold Miller, Reggie Archer, the left end. We got a punter coming in for a visit, a kicker, middle linebacker Asher Yodea, the subscriber, Noah Harrell, Jarrett Johnson, Patrick Hawkins, and Blake Jackson. So we'll take a look at recruiting probably in a later episode fully, but we'll take a look at the conference standings as Illinois Tech right now number 1 in the East at 2-0, and in the West, there's Western Michigan and Ball State, both at 2-0 with no conference games played quite yet. Conference play does begin, I believe, this week or next week for the entire conference. So here's your Heisman Top 5: Watson, Hilleman, Jamabo. Josh Rosen and Leonard Fournette, who had a really horrible game against FCS Southeast. Only 8 carries and 34 yards. You deserve to drop off the Heisman list. But here is the roster for the Bearcats. Of course, we are very familiar with this organization or this program. Won 2 national championships with them in the wide receiver player franchise, and they've got a lot of talent, including quarterback Hayden Moore, who is out with an injury. So 2 games in a row where the starting quarterback is injured. So starting will be Ross Trail, who is much more agile, much more of a runner. Here is the running back, very good, very speedy, and our secondary is going to have a tough time in this game if we see what we think we're seeing here. Look at the speed from these guys. I mean, Avery Johnson is very fast, and of course, that's going to lead to Kirk Herbstreit going with the number 25 Bearcats to win this ballgame. Illinois Tech is probably right on the edge of being ranked this year. Massively helped out by the win over Louisville, but of course, we've been playing pretty well since last year. But that, guys, will do it for this episode of the Illinois Tech Dynasty. 2-0 start to the year, taking on 1-1 number 25 Cincinnati on the road. So the big question, I know that everyone wants a recruiting update. I'm thinking about either doing it between this game and the game against Cincinnati, or doing it after the game against Cincinnati. So I haven't recorded anything yet, but let me know down below in the comments. Do you want to see it now or do you want to see it after this upcoming game? But that, guys, is going to do it for me. As always, if you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a like, subscribe if you're new, and I will see you guys next time for either a recruiting update or week 4 of season 2 of the Dynasty. Hope you guys enjoyed. See you later. Have a nice evening.